Philanthropy means etymologically, the love of humanity, in the sense of caring, nourishing, developing, and enhancing what it means to be human. In this meaning, it involves both the benefactor in their identifying and exercising their values, and the beneficiary in their receipt and benefit from the service or goods provided. A conventional modern definition is private initiatives, for public good, focusing on quality of life, which combines an original humanistic tradition with a social scientific aspect developed in the 20th century. The definition also serves to contrast philanthropy with business endeavors, which are private initiatives for private good, for example, focusing on material gain, and with government endeavors, which are public initiatives for public good, for example, focusing on provision of public services. A person who practices philanthropy is called a philanthropist. Philanthropy has distinguishing features from charity. Not all charity is philanthropy, or vice versa, though there is a recognized degree of overlap in practice. A difference commonly cited is that charity aims to relieve the pain of a particular social problem, whereas philanthropy attempts to address the root cause of the problem. The difference between the proverbial gift of a fish to a hungry person, versus teaching them how to fish. The literal, classical definitions and understandings of the term philanthropy derive from its origins in the Greek, which combines the word philos for loving and anthropo for human being, see below. The most conventional modern definition is private initiatives, for public good, focusing on quality of life. This combines the social scientific aspect developed in the century with the original humanistic tradition, and serves to contrast philanthropy with business, private initiatives for private good, focusing on material prosperity, and government, public initiatives for public good, focusing on law and order. These distinctions have been analyzed by Olivier Zunes, and others. Instances of philanthropy commonly overlap with instances of charity, though not all charity is philanthropy, or vice versa. The difference commonly cited is that charity relieves the pains of social problems, whereas philanthropy attempts to solve those problems at their root causes. The difference between giving a hungry person a fish, and teaching them how to fish. The word was first coined as an adjective by the playwright Aeschylus in Prometheus Bound, 5th century BCE. To describe Prometheus' character as humanity-loving, philanthropotropo, for having given to the earliest proto-humans who had no culture, fire, symbolizing technological civilization, and blind hope, optimism. Together, they would be used to improve the human condition, to save mankind from destruction. Thus, in the perspective of this early writer, humans were distinguished from all other animals by being a civilization with the power to complete their own creation through education, self-development, and culture, civic development, expressed in good works benefiting others. The new word, philanthropo, combined two words, philos, loving, in the sense of benefiting, caring for, nourishing, and anthropo, human being, in the sense of humanity, or humanness. The first use of the noun form philanthropia came shortly thereafter, c. 390 BCE, in the early Platonic dialogue Euthyphro. Socrates is reported to have said that his pouring out of his thoughts freely, without charge, to his listeners was his philanthropia. In the 1st century BCE, both paideia and philanthropia were translated into Latin by the single word humanitas, which was also understood to be the core of liberal education Studia Humanitatis, the studies of humanity, or simply the humanities. In the 2nd century CE, Plutarch used the concept of philanthropia to describe superior human beings. This classically synonymous troika, of philanthropy, the humanities, and liberal education, declined with the replacement of the classical world by Christianity. During the Middle Ages, philanthropia was superseded by caritas, charity, selfless love, valued for salvation. Philanthropy was modernized by Sir Francis Bacon in the 1600s, who is largely credited with preventing the word from being owned by horticulture. Bacon considered philanthropia to be synonymous with goodness, which correlated with the Aristotelian conception of virtue, as consciously instilled habits of good behavior. Then in the 1700s, an influential lexical figurehead by the name of Samuel Johnson simply defined philanthropy as love of mankind. Good nature. This definition still survives today and is often cited more gender-neutrally as the love of humanity. However, it was Noah Webster who would more accurately reflect the word usage in American English. The precise meaning of philanthropy is still a matter of some contention, its definition being largely dependent on the particular interests of the writer employing the term. Nevertheless, there are some working definitions to which the community associated with the field of philanthropic studies most commonly subscribes. One of the more widely accepted of these is the one employed by Lester Solomon, who defines philanthropy as the private giving of time or valuables, money, security, property, for public purposes, and or one form of income of private non-profit organizations.